Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And as you know, it is winter here in Southern California. So we wanted to find ways that we can keep our garden going and keep it sustainable, even though it's frigid outside at night. And so we came up with this solution using hydroponics in our garage to grow lettuce. And no, not that kind of lettuce. We're talking about romaine lettuce and different other kinds of lettuce. Now, you can go out, and you've probably seen the ads on Facebook or Instagram, all those $4,000 hydroponic systems. Well, you don't need that. You need literally about $20 in filament for a 3D printer. A 3D printer, which we have a couple of. And a couple of things we'll get to in just a second. So, the tower. All that you need to do is print off a bunch of these. Now, I made these out of a filament called PLA Plus. You could use PETG or a few other different types of filaments, but I have a link to the filament I used down below. These are awesome because on the bottom, they have like filters so that they can filter water down. But also, you can stack them, they interlock pretty easily. So I made about 6 of these, and we'll talk about why that's important in a second. Now, how hydroponics works, at least how we're gonna work it, is we're gonna mount all of these on a bucket, and there's gonna be a small water pump in the bottom of that bucket that's gonna run vinyl hose up through this little hole here and up to the very top. After we get all 5 or 6 of those, we have our top part here. Now that hose will go up here and it'll kind of lock in just like any of the other pieces to the top. And basically the water comes out the top and filters down in through these holes on this piece, as you can see, and then filters down through all of the different sections. We do have to make sure to have a cap that we also printed so the water doesn't go everywhere. Now, it's important to note that you have the different plant spots right here. So we're gonna start some seedlings, and after those have been going for a while, a week or two, which is what ours are at right now, we're gonna put them in these little net cups is what they're calling them. You can get these on Amazon as well. The link is below in the description for these. And then this basically sits right in here perfectly. And you can put your plants in here. And as you can see, when the water dips through, it'll get everything nice and wet from the bottom. And eventually the roots will start growing down in through here and they'll get more water and nutrients. So the other things that you're going to need for this project, you're gonna need some nutrient solution. You can get this on Amazon. Once again, link is below for this stuff. You're gonna use a pretty simple solution of 4 ounces to every gallon of water in your bucket that you're gonna be cycling through. You are gonna wanna increase that every few weeks as your plants are starting to grow so they get all the nutrients that they need. The other things you're gonna need are a timer for your pump to pump water through it because you don't want it going all day. And you're also going to need a light. Because yes, plants do need light to grow, surprise. So you can go out to, you know, your local hardware store and get some of the really like expensive incandescent bulbs that are gonna eat up your electricity. Or you can go to Amazon using the link below, and I have a nice setup with, it's got 4 LED lights that are the grow light temperature that you can adjust as necessary, and it doesn't use very much electricity at all. So once you have all of your stuff printed and you got all of your stuff from Amazon, we're gonna go out to the garage and put everything together and see how it goes. All right, first things first, the most important thing is your seedlings. You start these in these trays where we had the plastic covers to begin with that we got on Amazon, surprise. And when you, these come in little pellets basically, and when you get them wet, they expand into this, and these are peat moss, so they'll work really well in your hydroponics setup. We've let these grow for about 2 weeks, and after they sprouted, we went ahead and removed the cover, and so that way they could get accustomed to the cold without getting shocked too bad. Then we also use a mat to keep them warm on the bottom, and that helps them to sprout. Not all of them have sprouted, as you can see, but enough of them have that this should be an interesting experiment, at least for our first time. So we'll take these down here to our setup and we'll show you what we got. First thing I'll note, because it's up here high, is the light. This thing, it was fairly inexpensive. It was about 30 bucks. And as you can see, it's got 4 of these like squiggly arm light bulb heads, and it's on a light stand, so it's really easy to use. And it also comes in with a built-in timer. I'm probably gonna cut that out, but we'll see how it works just because I wanna be able to control it better myself. So let's go down here to the actual tower. All right, so as you can tell here, we got our bucket. And basically, if you use a hole saw to cut a hole in the top lid of the bucket, then this should screw right in just fine. Under the top cover of the bucket, though, If you can see in here, we have our pump and it's connected to some of the vinyl tubing going up the tower. So how we're gonna assemble this is, we've got our vinyl tubing that's running up to the top here. We're gonna snake that through our last segment. And secure all that down. Make sure to get enough of the tubing out here. And then this is gonna plug into the little nipple that's on the bottom. Now we're gonna put our cap on here, make sure water doesn't go literally everywhere. Next thing we're gonna do is get our liquid plant food. I went ahead and added just one capful into the water here, just cause it's one capful or 4 milliliters for every gallon. So super important because your plants do need nutrients because it's just gonna have water. So something to note here, if you follow the link to the Thingiverse file, which I'll have below, cause this is free, you just can't sell it. It'll give you these cups, which will actually lock into place and everything in here and work really well. Problem is, these take forever to print, use up a lot of filament, and they'll tend to break after one use, so we're not using it. That's why we got these. These were like, I don't know, between $5 and $10 for a ton of them, and we got them on Amazon, and it only took 2 days to get here. So to get started here, because we don't have all of our sprouts out, like some of them didn't sprout at all, we're gonna take the ones that did sprout and put them on the front here, because that's where they will get the most light. So all we're gonna do is take, it's very simple, and drop them in this cup. And then all we're gonna do here is drop them down in just like that. So we'll go ahead and get these in, and I'll check back in with you in a second. So we do have about 5 of these pellets that nothing sprouted out of, but I'm gonna put them on the back just to see if anything comes out of them while we start growing here. Okay, well that is all set. So we are gonna lower our light here and just get it adjusted so that way we're getting the right amount of light on all of our plants. Alrighty. Looking good. So basically the only other step here, sorry for this pole, that's just my garage, is I'm gonna do a quick water test to make sure there's no leaks. And if that's the case, then I'm just gonna set up the water to water probably for 20 or so minutes twice a day for now, just to make sure everything stays nice and wet and nutrientized. So let's take a test with the water. Well, that seemed to work really well. So for the timer for the pump, I just have a really simple like Christmas light timer, you know, it's really simple to use and set up. So I'm just gonna call it probably 6 in the morning. I'm gonna set one of these down and probably another one of these at 6 p.m. Well, that's it for our setup. We're gonna just monitor this and see how it goes over the next couple weeks, but hopefully we get some nice lettuce. If we didn't mention, there's some romaine and some Waldman's green lettuce in here. So we're looking forward to it. If you need any of the things we use to get this set up, they're down below in the description, as well as the STL files for the 3D printers. Or if you need a 3D printer to go along with that, they'll be down in the description as well. Otherwise, make sure to check in here in a couple weeks and we'll let you know how it's going with our hydroponics.